guys, welcome back to my channel. This is Victoria, just your average girl on YouTube, and welcome to my first ever vlog. I am going to Calgary and it is right now 4:30. I'm about to leave. My friend is already here to pick me up and drive me to the airport, and I hope you guys come along with me and I'll show you what Alberta is all about, if it's worth the hype. My dad just picked me up with my brother and we are gonna go grab some breakfast. And then we're gonna figure out what we're gonna do in the day. That's the update. The flight went by pretty quick. It was so uncomfortable. The seats were so close to each other, very little leg room. I was so cold. And at the end of the flight, I realized that a vent was blowing on me the whole time that I could have just closed. Anyways, the end was fine. I wasn't cold at the end and we arrived a little bit late, but anyways, I'm here now. We're gonna grab some brekkie and I'll update you later. Okay guys, so we just finished eating. I dropped off my stuff at the Airbnb and we're gonna go to our first activity for the day. We're gonna head to Icefield Parkway stops, We're gonna drive through Icefield Parkway stop, which is supposed to be like a really nice, most scenic route of this place. We're gonna stop at 7 points. I'm not sure if we're gonna make it all the way to the 7th point because it is quite far. Just to get to the 1st point, it takes about 2 hours car drive. But we will see. I'm really excited. My brain feels like a raisin though. Every time I'm on an airplane, my brain just dries up. How pretty is the view from our street? And this is our little car for our stay here. Which is Herbert Lake, so let's see how it is. Water is really clear. Again, the disappointing thing is that you're supposed to see the mountains in the background, but you can't because of the smoke. I need my money back. To our second stop on the, what is it called, Iceland Parkway? Anyways, we just arrived to our second stop, which is the Hector Lake.
Ice grounds, I think?
No, not ice grounds. And it's supposed to take about 45 minutes one way and then 45 minutes back. It's about a 2 kilometers walk. or trail, and we'll see how it's gonna be. I will update you guys throughout the way.
Looking like a really, really cute trail so far. They said it's gonna get a bit muddier. It's very muddy here.
We got to this point where we're supposed to walk across this river. Should we attempt it or should we not? We should. Let's risk it. So, how was falling in the river?
Good.
Just soaked. That was fun. The water was so cold. And the water bottle is gonna be lost forever. The Sheridan water bottle.
Nice. Nice.
We made it to Hector's lake. It's so beautiful, so quiet here. It's incredible. It's just so beautiful. And I can only imagine how much more beautiful it would be if it wasn't as smoky. But even like this, it's just beautiful. Maybe even prettier than Lake Louise, but we haven't seen Lake Louise yet. Wow, I'm just speechless how quiet it is. Hector Lake, 10 out of 10. Definitely recommend that you do the hour hike. It took us about 57 minutes to get here. Now we're gonna take another hour to get back. And then we still have about 5 more stops to do. And I think it's 3 o'clock already. Or 4 almost. We will see how far we get today. It's 3 o'clock. And I need to find a washroom too. So much fun. This area really challenged us. His feet got stuck in the mud. I couldn't get it out. We just finished the hike. It was quite an uphill walk. It was a little bit challenging to come upward than going down, but it still took us about an hour. Now we're gonna see if we're gonna make it to the next stop or maybe we'll get some food because we haven't eaten since the morning. We ran into a little problem. Oh my gosh. One of our tires is kind of stuck, the brake on it, and we don't even have a lifter and we don't have service. We literally can't even call anyone and we are so far away, like 3 hours away from our location, and I don't know what we're gonna do. I hope we figure things out. Okay, we made it to our next stop, the third stop at Bow Lake, and it looks gorgeous.
Look at these guys without their shoes.
Look at these two.
And then look at my Crocs, my cute Crocs. And then the beautiful view. It's spectacular.
Okay, I think our tire got fixed by itself, thankfully. We were just gonna risk it and then go ahead. Hopefully we're not gonna have anything unlucky happening to us, because there's no service, you can't call anyone, there's no freaking equipment in this car if this car ends up breaking down. Like, what kind of a car owner is this guy? Alright guys, our next stop would have been Paito Lake, but we just saw the sign that it says it's closed. Not sure why, but we are moving on to the next stop, which is Mistaya Canyon, but we have no idea how far it is because we had no access to maps or anything. So it could be really far or really close. I have no idea, but the view is beautiful. Deciding to turn back soon and look at the background here too. It's just too beautiful.
This thing is fire. It tastes so good. It's two wafers and some caramel in the inside in the middle.
It's called Stroopwafel.
And look at the beautiful view too. But yeah, this is our last stop. Right now it's 6 o'clock? What time is it?
5:15.
It's 5:15. It's still a little bit early, but I think we have about 3 hours ahead of us to get back to our place, and we're probably just gonna go to sleep early so we can wake up tomorrow and go to our next location for day two, which we are planning to go to Johnson's Canyon. So that's what our plan is. Yeah. Video. Currently it is 10:51 p.m. Today was a lot of fun. We got super tired. I'm going to sleep now, and tomorrow we're going to Johnson's Canyon. We're waking up at 6:45 a.m. My back is killing me. I've been sitting so much, first in the airplane and then after that just in the car for a long, long time. Anyways, I will see you guys tomorrow morning. Bye.